The plaque here beside me, right in the heart of Dublin's Docklands at St Laurence O'Toole National School, was unveiled on the 12th of May 2016, 100 years to the day of James Connolly's execution by British soldiers. The Docklands were a heartland for the Irish Citizen Army, with many of its members coming from the communities in East Wall, Ringsend and the surrounding areas. Work on the docks was precarious and dangerous, and because of this, the Docklands was a hotbed for industrial agitation. James Larkin himself became politically aware as a result of his time working on the docks in Liverpool. In the Dublin Docklands, even the kids are radicalised. In 1911, the boys of the East Wall National School, who were only between 8 and 14 years old, famously went on strike, demanding shorter hours, cheaper books and an end to canings. The people of the Dublin Dockland communities greeted the food ship, the SS Hare, when it arrived during the 1914 lockout. The ship was loaded with supplies sent by British workers to assist their comrades in Ireland who were on strike. The Dublin Docklands community played a crucial role in the story of the Citizen Army. Many locals from East Wall were actually members of the Citizen Army who were central to the organisation right throughout its existence. Here's Tell Us More is local historian from East Wall, Joe Mooney.
If you look at this road, there's 70 houses on it. They were built by the Merchants Warehousing Company, which is one of the biggest companies based in the docks, had their own carton firm. They built these houses in 1908 and forced their employees to move into it. And then come 1913, the workers were members of the ITGWU. They were out on strike, they were locked out, and the company made them give up their houses and replace them with scabs. So you had, in the run-up to Christmas 1913, you had 62 workers and their families, somewhere between 200 and 300 people, were evicted off this road. Amongst those numbers would have been the Courtney family. The Courtney family were the first family to move into this road. And Daniel was an organiser with the Transport and General Workers Union. He was the father. Then joined the Citizen Army, and himself and his son would have fought in 1916. So from this area you had people who were the lifeblood of the Union, would then go into the Citizen Army and would then take part in 1916 in the rebellion. Probably the most important person politically would have been Walter Carpenter. Walter Carpenter was one of the most prominent socialists in the city. He was essentially, in some ways, he was James Connolly's right-hand man. He was the secretary of the Irish Socialist Party under Connolly. Now, Walter lived in the area, and his two sons joined the Citizen Army on his formation. The lockout was only the beginning. Of course, they very famously took part in the 1916 rising. But by 1917, as soon as they were back in the country after Frongoch, etc., they were reorganising. They would have been active throughout the War of Independence. People like Robert de Corps moved into the area and was at the heart of the area. People like Willie Halpin was working in the Dublin Dockyard, getting jobs for every socialist and republican in the area, while robbing it blind of equipment, etc. They were scouting the docks, and of course they set up an arms route from Scotland. That was during the War of Independence. When it came to the treaty and the split for the Civil War, the majority of the Citizen Army went with the anti-treaty side, and throughout that period in the Docklands, the Citizen Army were active, and the men and women of the Citizen Army were active throughout that period.
It's very clear over 100 years later that the people from the Docklands community and East Wall are very proud of the role that the Citizen Army played in this area.